title of the service is running the race. Running the race. So, what's really interesting is I'm a big fan of sports. I'm a big fan of sports. And I find it so intriguing to find out how kids were before they became famous. So, big guess. Who is this person on the projection screen? Usain Bolt. Hands up if you didn't know them. Okay. Now this is really interesting. For those people who didn't know it was Usain Bolt, check this out. This is a very interesting point. This is Usain Bolt when he was 11 years old. Do you think he knew he was going to be the fastest man in the world at that age?
Yes.
Now some people say yes. I can tell you no. I can tell you no. At this age, he's never even run 100 meters before. Never run it before. Now, what's really interesting is this. What's Usain Bolt got to do with you? A lot. Why? Because people look at you at the age that you are, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and no one knows who you're going to become. Your ability to be successful in life depends on many things. But one key thing is this. Do you believe that you're capable of something special?
Yes.
I like that answer. Yes. I can tell you, at 11 years old, Usain Bolt had bullies. I can tell you, at 11 years old, not everyone said things that strengthened him, that encouraged him. We've all been 11 years old. We've got people in school who are forever hating on us. Forever hating. But what's interesting is this. Now we know his future. I can ask you this question. Did the hating or the negativity affect his destiny? No. I want to tell you right now. You may not be the fastest man or woman in the world, but God has made you destined for your life. The question is, are you bold to find out what it is? Now, what's really interesting is when he said that I want to be grateful, 95 seconds, it changed everything. Everything. I remember watching it, I was like 21 at the time. And when he crossed the line, he was jogging. And that's a world record. Everyone has a race to run. And your success in your race is not going to come by accident. Every athlete is dedicated to whatever sport they're connected to. Every athlete. It's the dedication of the athlete which sponsors buy into. It's the dedication of the student that big companies buy into. It's not about getting an A-star in and of itself. What an A-star represents is someone who's dedicated. Every hour of this man's day, every food that went into his mouth was calculated. His success was not by accident. Just like your success will not be by accident. Amen? Okay. Let's get started. I said to myself, okay, well, Lord, what message do you want me to bring today? Like, what do you want me to say? And he said this, he said, there's a lot of people, there's a lot of kids who are going to be there today who have a misunderstanding, now my phone please, a misunderstanding of what Christianity is. I didn't volunteer, you don't know how I do, I mean, one volunteer. It's going to be bold, there you go, come on. Could you get the black scarf inside that bag? Could you tie that black scarf around your eyes, please? Now, before I take the message any further, it's very, very important that you understand this first thing first. The question is, can you see? Good, she cannot see. Okay, I'm gonna guide her. Just be careful. Turn around. Go this way. Now, this is Moses. Alright, I'm gonna use Moses for a second. Her aim is to get to Moses without touching any of the barriers. Are you cheating? Good. Okay, get to Moses. Take a step forward. You go. Already she's here. That's her first step. A lot of people think that Christianity is based on sin avoidance. So we think, oh, okay, that's sin. That's not Christianity. That's not Christianity. But a lot of people think that is Christianity, and that's why a lot of people think Christianity is boring. Because these hurdles, these dilemmas, these situations in life are always going to be there. I'm not going to tell you, stop sinning. Stop sinning. Stop sinning. That's the wrong message. A lot of you guys are saying this, and there's a lot of condemnation. So when, take a step back, I want to move it around to make it easier for you. Now take a step forward. Oh, she hit already. When we sin, we feel so condemned. Some of us, many of us in this room will say, you know what, can't go to New Gen. Can't go to church this Sunday. Can't pray to God. I just can't do it because I'm forever hitting this hurdle. I'm forever sinning. But guys, I want you to know this. God isn't angry at you because you sin. He's not angry at you because you hit the hurdle. The purpose of God's love is this, and I want everyone to remember this. Even if, take a step forward, and again, you hit the hurdle constantly. All God is saying is this, don't worry, I still love you, come again. Walking a sin-free life is based on this, and remember this, it's based on knowing that God loves you, and you reciprocate it. When you start reciprocating the love of God for you, what happens? Is that you see. Now get to Moses without touching the barrier. It's based on spiritual sight. And spiritual sight comes when you receive God's love for your life. Not for my life. Don't think I'm special because I'm the pastor. I'm not. But the level of sin that you're in is based automatically and directly on how much you believe God loves you and has forgiven you for everything that you've ever done. Amen? Amen. Now you may think that's hard. That's hard to believe, Pastor Angie. That's really hard. I'm not sure if I can do that. I'm not sure if I can accept that. It sounds too good to be true. That's why it's called grace. It's called the good news. The gospel is the good news. The good news is it's not about the Savior. On the cross, he sorted this. On the cross, it represents his love for you. This doesn't matter anymore. Now, some of you in your minds are thinking, wait, hold on. If it doesn't matter anymore,
let me do it too.
I'm not saying that. Don't do that. Because by doing that, you missed it. It's not that God doesn't care about you sinning. God's giving you grace. What that grace means is this. The life he's given you is designed to live beyond the sin. That's the whole purpose of grace. And if you so happen to sin, he's saying, don't worry, keep your eyes on me. The love of God is so profound and so simple. And that is the key thing that sets people free. There's some in this room who are still so condemned, so guilty, so ashamed of the things that they do in secret. You don't feel worthy. I'm saying this. Faith goes beyond your feelings. Faith is true. The question is, do you believe it for you? Amen?